Hi all, I have been recommended another amazing game to show you today, Leela against Stockfish. This was in the Chesscom Blitz Bonanza final, 5 minutes with a 2 second increment. The opening book given to both, Leela playing with the white pieces, plays e4, and we have the Pirc opening, g6 here. This is the end of the book. Now, bishop e3 from Leela. So, a very strong move. It is as though playing against the Sicilian dragon, you normally want to play queen d2, f3, and castle queenside. Here we have bishop g7, queen d2, black castles, f3. So, a very interesting setup indeed. c6, white castles, queenside. h5. Fischer once said against the dragon something like, you just open up the h-file, sack, sack, and mate, something like that, in the Fischer Memorable Games book. So it's interesting, can white get any attack going here in this position, which seems a little bit like a Sicilian dragon? We have a very interesting move. H5 is already out of normal book. Normally b5 is played, and some games have followed like this: king b1, bishop going to h6. And it's thought to have some equal chances, believe it or not, this position. But here, h5, you might think this is extreme prophylaxis against g4. But in fact, Leela rebels and plays g4 anyway. H takes g. There's no point trying to play h4 here. The queen could just drop back and hit h4. Nothing's going to be protecting that there. Big advantage for white. So h takes g. And now h4, this is a little bit curious, this order, but it seems as though it's doing the job of opening up some files, which is what you want to do against the opponent's king. And time is of the essence in an opposite side castling scenario like this. So a very, very exciting start position, really. Well, from the opening, earlier in the opening. But Leela's playing super aggressively. b5. If black takes this pawn, it's just helping white. Here's a fictional scenario. The h-file could basically be used, even with an exchange sack, it will be accelerating white's attack. And it's just, these scenarios are extremely dangerous. This is just a fictional one, where knight b5 for bishop c5 check, and black's king is getting basically slaughtered in these scenarios. That's one fictional scenario there. So anyway, b5, so trying to keep things closed for the moment as much as possible. h5, trying to open things up again. Knight takes, bishop h6. So is it really the case that this attack is dangerous? We have f6 being played. If we look at the alternative, bishop takes h6, queen takes, say e5, this scenario, the lines do tend to get opened up. So in this fictional scenario, white is sacking the exchange and using the h-file, for example, with a big advantage. It can get to really dangerous situations. So f6, that is what Stockfish believes is the right defense here. Look at how many pawns black has moved, actually, and all the pieces on the back row there. We have bishop d3, e5, f takes g4. So this is opening up more lines taking here, the f-file exposure potentially. Bishop takes, bishop e2, and the g-file, semi up f, g, and h-files. If we look at this, the attacking pressure potentially is quite large because of these semi-open files. Queen d7, and now rook h4, nudging that bishop away, trying to lift the blockades now on the semi-open files. And in fact, white is now potentially threatening rook takes and rook g1. So it's already looking pretty desperate, this situation. Yeah, this spells severe danger for the black king, this scenario already. So king h7 was played. If we look at alternative bishop takes, then queen takes, queen g7, rook takes. This is just, it's all too strong because there's the idea of rook g1 if g takes. It's all too strong for white. White's getting a big advantage. So king h7 was chosen. We have bishop takes, queen takes. king b1. And that's an interesting move to stop queen h6. The queen's coming off. unnecessary detail in the midst of what seems to be a ferocious attacking game to play king b1. But yeah, sometimes it's needed. King g8. And now rook takes h5. Yeah, this was just desperate, king g8. But what is black doing here? So rook takes. This now wins the queen. Is it the end of the story, just winning the queen here? By move 20, it seems as though Leela's really smashed up this Pirc. Is the Pirc really that unplayable that Stockfish is getting this position? Queen takes, knight takes. Let's see what happens now. So plan A, Leela is getting the knight now to f5. That's plan A with this position. Okay, bit of an attack from black there for a moment, it seemed. A takes, but yeah, these pawns are all weak, actually. These pawns are now being taken as well. And the queen is looking pretty menacing, threatening queen g3 check potentially there sometimes. Yeah, black's just shedding pawns. And it looks as though there's not much for black to do here. This really does look... That knight on f5 looks formidable, and the pawn's on the queen side now. So let's see how this continues. They're giving up that knight. Check, check. Look at all these passed pawns. The two rooks, it would seem very, very unlikely for the two rooks to be able to do anything against the four extra pawns. Well, three extra pawns now, but the three connected passed pawns look absolutely winning visually crushing. And in fact, queen takes d6 here is transitioning to a totally one position after a7. There's no stopping the pawns here after c7. King b7, yep, one pawn is enough after this, you know, threatening c8. So one pawn is enough, and that's it. Pretty sweet crush of the Pirc defense. It looks as though what Fischer said about the dragon is what Leela is doing to Stockfish's Pirc defense, just opening up the H file, sack and mate nearly. Here, queen e1, checkmate. So quite a crushing game there. Very interesting, these encounters. And at the moment, it seems as though Leela's ahead of the field, significantly ahead of Stockfish at the moment. So looks to be set to be, at the moment, winning this Blitz Bonanza final. But there's quite a few games to go, so things can change. If you enjoyed this game video, then please click on the top left box, which should appear shortly, to become a member at chessworld.net, to play against other YouTubers. You can also test yourself on variations in this and other games from the improved menu, Puzzle Books option, which has a link to the annotated game. Comments, questions, donations, see the description. Like, shares, subscribes with that notification bell. Really appreciated. Thanks very much.